गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, दिस इज प्रणव जैन, बीटेक सीएससी फोर्थ सेमेस्टर एंड माय टॉपिक इज एज ट्रिगर्ड फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स। नाउ बिफोर नोइंग व्हाट आर एज ट्रिगर्ड फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स, वी शुड नो व्हाट आर फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स एंड इन जनरल व्हाट आर लॉजिक सर्किट्स। सो देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ लॉजिक सर्किट्स, कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट एंड सिक्वेंशियल सर्किट। सो इन कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट्स इट्स द सिंपलेस्ट वन। कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट डज नॉट यूज एनी मेमोरी, so the output depends on the present input only. But in the case of sequential circuit, we have the memory element which stores the data. So in sequential circuit, output can vary based on the input. This type of circuit uses previous input, output, clock and the memory element. Now what are flip-flops? Let's see the basic definition. A flip-flop is an electronic circuit with two stable states and that can be used to store binary data. Hence, we can say flip-flops are used as data storage elements. It is the basic storage element in sequential logic. So, there are four types of flip-flops. First one is set-reset type, which is also known as SR flip-flop. This is the basic storage device, data storage device, which holds data until the reset occurs. Now, the second one is JK flip-flop. This is the most versatile of basic flip-flops. The third one is D-type. This is basic data type flip-flop that has advantage over the JK flip-flop because it has simpler wiring than the JK version. Now, the fourth one is toggle. Toggle action is useful for counters. Now, there are SR flip-flops, also known as SR latch, is known as set-reset type flip-flops, where the set means the output equal to 1 is labeled S and 1, which will reset the device, meaning the output 0, is labeled R. So, there are two types of SR flip-flop. SR NOR flip-flop using NOR gates and SR NAND flip-flops using NAND gates. Now, the basic problem with SR flip-flop is that when the condition arises that when S equal to 0 and R equal to 0, this SR NAND gate is not used and it should be avoided. So, JK flip-flop is used in the condition of not using SR because it is advanced version. So it is the universal flip-flop circuit, and as stated earlier, JK flip-flop has no invalid or forbidden input states of SR latch even when S and R both are at logic 0 or logic 1, considered to which SR we are using, NAND or NOR. Now there are four types of possible input combination in JK flip-flop: logic 1, logic 0, no change and toggle. So here we can see that it is using the SR flip-flop, which is in this box, and this S and this R is connected to two NAND gates and it is given to the clock and J and K. So JK flip-flop has a symbol which is stated in this diagram and it works on this table. Now here comes the D-type flip-flop. It is the better alternative than very popular digital electronics. Now D-type flip-flop is also known as data-type flip-flop because it is used to store data, and can also be known as delay-type flip-flop because it also depends on time. Now we see that problem with basic JK flip-flop is the timing problem called the race. In this, it happens that output Q changes state before the timing pulse of the clock input has time to go off, and hence we have to avoid timing pulse period, must keep as short as possible, and we know that frequency is 1 upon time period, so we have to keep high frequency. And now we see, hence we have to remove the Same as above, the IE, the timing problem called race, and to remove feedback effect and the glitches, we will see in further in the PPT, we have to use master slave D flip-flop. This is edge triggering flip-flop. So now let's start flip-flop triggering. So triggering is bringing a small change in input signal that will affect the output, and this is done with the use of bringing clock pulse known as trigger pulse. So we see clock response in flip-flop. Flip-flop are constructed in such way as to make them operate properly when they are part of sequential circuits that employs a common clock. And here we can see in the diagram that these all three are the clock pulses. So this one is the responsive positive cycle that only works at the positive cycle. This clock pulse go through two transition, which is stated in these board diagrams. From 0 to 1, which is the positive edge response, and from 1 to 0, this which is known as negative edge response. So master slave flip-flop, also known as negative edge triggering flip-flop, is constructed with a D flip-flop with 2D latches and an inverter as shown in the figure below. The first latch is now called as master latch, and the second is known as the slave. Now we can see this master and this latch flip-flop in this diagram. This is a master latch. This one is the master latch, and this is the slave latch. And as stated earlier, it uses JK flip-flop. So these are connected to another NAND gates and then to JK and the clock. So we see three stages. Like we can see, when the clock is zero, when we have clock equal to zero, then the D latch of master won't work, because here the output here it will be zero, and here because of this not, we will have one in this. So only the slave will work, and Q output is equal to the master output Y. The second condition is when the clock, we take it as 1. If we take it as 1, then what happens? If we take it as 1, this becomes 0. So latch don't work. Latch is disabled. But the master one will work. And hence, we will get the output but cannot affect the slave output. Stage 3 is when the clock pulse return to 0, i.e. when we are going from 1 to 0. So we will see the master is disabled and isolated from the input D, and slave is enabled, and the value of Y is transferred in to give us the output Q. And hence we can see that flip-flop is triggered only at the negative edge, i.e. while going from 1 to 0. So from this behavior we can note down 3 points, that the output may change only once. A change in output is triggered by the negative edge of the clock, and the change may occur only during the clock's negative cycle. Other than that, it will be in the steady state. No such occurrence of change takes place, and hence this is known as negative edge triggering. Like in this diagram we can see, we have clock and we have D. So considering QN and QP, which are the graph symbol for the negative the negative edge and this QP stands for positive edge. We can find out that QS is equal to QN in the case of master slave, and hence we can prove through graph also that this is a negative edge triggering. Now comes the positive edge triggered flip-flop. So in this, D flip-flop uses three SR latches and are connected. Two latches respond to the external D data and clock inputs. The third latch provides the output of the flip-flop for the flip-flop. So this one is the output one that provides its output, but here the input comes from this. So we will see the four cases. Let's go to the four cases and let's see the diagram. So when we take CP equal to 0, that is the clock pulse equal to 0, the first condition at D equal to 0. So if clock pulse equal to 0, this is equal to 0 and this is equal to 0. And we can see that because of NAND, if any input is 0, we will have output as 1. So 1 will go to here and 1 will go to here, and we have 1 and here 0 as 1 and this one, and 1 will go back to here and this will all give 1, 1 and 1 equal to 0. So we have S equal to 1 and R equal to 1 in this case. So we can see S equal to 1 and R equal to 1. So we can see that if Q equal to 0, Q is considered to be 0, so we will have through this is 0 and 1 and 0 NAND equal to 1. So Q not equal to 0, and we can consider it as 1 after taking Q not here. So we will have 1 and 1 as 0. So we can see it has got previous state. Same is in the condition with CP equal to 0 and D equal to 1. We will get the previous state. So now we will see what happens when D equal to 0 and CP equal to 1 and D equal to 1, CP equal to 1. So let's go. When we have CP equal to 1 and D equal to 0, and in the condition here we have 1 and 1 from the previous state. So we have 1 and 1. So this one will go to here and we have D equal to 0. So if any input is 0, we will have 1 here, and this 1 will go from here to here, and this 1 will go from here to here, and we have 1 and 1 as 0, which is here. So this 0 will go here, and we have CP equal to 1 here, and we can see there is 1 0, so we will have 1 here, which is here, and this 1 goes to here, and this 1 is here, and this 1 is also here, so we will have 0 as the output. So we will have S as 1 and R as 0. So if we take, now we have 0 here as input, so here it will become 1, because if any input in NAND gate is 0, then output will always be 1. So this 1 goes from here to here, and 1 and 1 equal to 0. So where Q is equal to 0 and Q not equal to 1, we can say that it is at a reset state. Now taking the last condition, which is CP equal to 1 and D equal to 1. We will see that doing the same kind of thing, we have 1 and 0 here. After solving, we will get 0 and 1. We will have 0 and 1. 0 and 1 here. So if we have 0 as an input, this Q will be 1 and this one goes here. We have 1 and 1 as 0. And hence we get the steady state at D equal to 1 and Cp equal to 1. Thank you.